activate Blippi Station. It's time to get up and shout. I wonder what we'll learn about Blippi.
Oh no! D.BO, look how the water is carrying the Frisbee far away towards that island.
I wonder, why don't islands float away?
You're right! Let's go ask the island and find out. I'm gonna need helicopter blades and duck feet.
Helicopter blades, duck feet, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure.
Oh, hello up there.
Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is D.BO.
Nice to meet you both. I'm Ivan.
Ivan, why don't you float away?
I think it has something to do with my bottom. Oh, I know. Let's look underwater where my bottom is to find out.
Oh, wait. I can't see down there.
You're right, D.BO. It would be great if you sucked up the water so we could see the bottom better.
I can't wait to see what's down there.
Okay, D.BO, drink up. Wow, these colorful coral reefs are so beautiful. We can see so much now. And Ivan, you're way bigger than I thought.
Thanks, I'm even bigger. You're only at my belly button now, see?
Oh, D.BO, can you drink up more water so we can see the bottom? Are you okay, D.BO? Ivan, you have so many amazing things on you. Hey, wait! Are we at the bottom now?
No! You have reached my knees! Still a bit of a way to go!
Do you think you've got one more big gulp left in you, D.BO? We're so close to being able to see the bottom! Woohoo! I knew you did!
You made it, Blippi! You're at my feet!
Really? How can you be sure?
Because it tickles when you walk around!
Ivan, you're attached to the bottom of the sea. You're like a mountain.
Oh, D.BO! Oh, no!
Well, that was fun, and now I have the answer to my question. Why don't islands float away? Islands don't float away because they are mountains attached to the seafloor.
Upload answer, D.BO.
Thanks for all your help, Ivan. You rock. Hope to see you again.
Anytime. I'm here to stay. Bye-bye, Blippi.
It's so hot out today, but my popsicle is melting down my hand. I wonder, why do popsicles melt down my hand? What's that, Tabs? Go into that ice cream truck and ask an expert? That's a great idea. I'm gonna need wings, the excavator arm, and duck feet.
Wings, excavator arm, duck feet, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure. Let's go find out why my popsicle always melts down my hand. Shrinking down! Woohoo! I'm in the ice cream truck.
Hi, welcome to my neighborhood. I'm Sherry Pop. Glad you popped in.
Hi, Sherry. It's me, Blippi. I was wondering why my popsicle always melts down my hand.
Oh, I know that one. But first, let's have some frozen fun.
All right. Woohoo! We're ice cream boarding.
We're sprinkle sliding. riding.
I'm Chocolate Mudge snorkeling. Sherry, are you melting?
Yes, I'm melting because I'm very warm. But I'll go cool off in the freezer and I'll be fine in a sec. Ice cold.
How's it going in there, Sherry?
It's freezy breezy. Now I'm all set.
Whoa, it looks super freezing in there.
Yep, it's cool to be cold when you're a frozen dessert like me. My ideal temperature is 32 degrees Fahrenheit, 0 degrees Celsius. If I keep cool like that, then I won't melt.
Good to know. I see you're like my popsicle from earlier. When it was out of the freezer and in the heat of the Blippi-mobile, it melted on me.
Sounds like your popsicle should have come for a visit.
You're right, which means we have the answer to my question. Why my popsicle melts down in my hand? It's because popsicles will melt if they get too warm. That's why we keep them in the freezer. Upload answer tabs. Sherry, thank you for a totally tasty... Wow! That's a pretty tall mountain. I'm sure there are way taller mountains, Tabs. I wonder, what's the tallest mountain in the world? Great idea, Tabs. We'll go to the Himalayas and find out. I'm gonna need wings and the grabber arm.
Wings, grabber arm, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure. Let's go find the tallest mountain in the world. Woohoo! Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is Tabs. We're looking for the tallest mountain.
I'm climbing it right now. Hi, I'm Betty the Yeti.
Yeti!
I was just headed to the top. That's where the best snow is. Nothing worse than old snow.
Can I tag along? I want to see what it's like on top of the tallest mountain.
Of course, but get ready. This mountain is super tall.
We're up so high, and it's much colder up here. Thanks, Tabs. I love hot cocoa.
Whoa!
Woo! Gotcha. Phew. That was a close one. Hey, it's the mountaintop. Yeah, we made it. Oh, whoa! It's so windy up here!
I got you, Blippi!
So, what is the name of this mountain?
It's Comalangma! Oh, you call it Mount Everest.
You're right, Tabs. I have the answer to my question. What's the tallest mountain in the world? It's Mount Everest! It's 29,035 feet tall. Upload answer tabs.
And the snow up here is delicious.
Bouncy sand dune. And even bouncier. Wow, what an amazing sandcastle. Wave incoming. Oh no. Looks like that castle was no match for that wave. I wonder, can I build a sandcastle that doesn't get washed away? Yeah, you're right, Tabs. There is only one way to find out. I need to build a sandcastle of my own. I'm gonna need the excavator arm and spider legs.
Excavator arm, spider legs, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi-mobile is ready for action. Let's go make a sandcastle that won't get washed away. Now we need to make ourselves sandcastle size. Shrinking down! Feel that cool ocean breeze, Tabs. Whoa!
Hi there! I'm Krabby the Crab. Pleasure to meet you! Ooh, crikey! I don't know my own strength!
Hi, Krabby. It's me, Blippi. And this is my Blippi-mobile.
I love it. So, you out taking a fun ride?
Actually, Krabby, I'm here because I'm curious if I can build a sandcastle that won't get washed away.
You came to the right crab. I'm a planner, digger, and a builder. I can help you, Blippi.
Great.
So the first thing we're gonna do is build a moat. That's a fancy word for a hole. You see, the water goes into the hole and doesn't wash away what's behind it. So, let's dig! Dig, 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 hoo!
Wow, what a hole!
Now let's build a sandcastle!
You're right, Tabs. We are gonna need a shovel.
Finished! Success!
You already built it, Krabby.
And our moat is perfect. The moat's the hole we dug all around the sandcastle.
Great moat! And best sandcastle ever. Wave incoming! The moat worked, Krabby. This means I think I have the answer to my question. Can I build a sandcastle that doesn't get washed away? I can by making a hole around it to catch the water. Upload answer, Tabs. Thanks, Krabby.
See you later, Blippi. Keep on digging.
Whoa, that bird is carrying lots of twigs. Right, D.BO. She's bringing them to her nest. I wonder, how do birds build a nest? Good idea! Let's follow that bird and see if she'll show us. I'm gonna need wings and a grabber arm.
Wings, grabber arm, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station! Shrinking down! The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure! Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is D.BO. Oh no! What happened to your nest?
Hi, Blippi and D.BO. I'm Jodie. My nest was damaged in a storm last night. Oh, don't worry, Eggies. Mama's on a mission to rebuild our nest.
We were wondering how you build a nest.
Well, I could use an extra wing to look after my two eggs.
D.BO would love to egg sit.
Aw, thanks, D.BO. Now, Blippi, can you come with me to get supplies? Grass, mud and twigs. They're all near Jake's place, so we'll need to keep him busy. Very unfriendly.
Let's go! Nice birdie! Jodie, what's the status of that grass?
Grass acquired. Time to get the mud. Mud is landing in the nest. Now all we need are some twigs from the end of this branch.
This guy again?
Thanks, D.BO. Time to build! First, I make a circle with twigs and grass. Then, add more twig circles higher on top of each other.
Whoa! You use your beak to build it!
The mud is like glue, holding the nest together.
Your nest is fantastic, Jodie! And I know the answer to my question. How do birds build a nest? Birds like Jodie find natural things like grass and twigs, then use mud to hold it all together. Upload answer, D.BO.
Bye, Blippi and D.BO. Thanks for all your help.
Bye-bye, Jody. Bye, Eggs. I love being at the beach. Whoa! A flying fish. I wonder, what's underneath the ocean? Good idea, Tabs. We can go into the ocean and find out. I'll need duck feet and a propeller.
Duck feet, propeller, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi Mobile is ready for adventure. Wow! It's a whole other world down here. Is this like some kind of underwater forest?
Exactly! It is a forest! Welcome to my neighborhood! My name's Jerry, Jerry the Jellyfish!
Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is Tabs. We're down here to see what's in the ocean.
Oh yeah, there's a lot. The ocean's full of surprises. I'll show you. I'm going to meet my friends. Well, I'll give you a tour along the way.
All right, thanks, Jerry.
First stop, our kelp forest. This kelp can grow up to 150 feet.
Wow, that's so tall.
Oh yeah, but sometimes the water current around here blows the kelp around.
Kelp! Kelp!
Oh no, this never happens.
Great idea, Tabs. Let's use the turbo boosters.
Oh, good. Glad you're okay. Let's move on.
Whoa! That fish is blue and has a long nose.
She's a blue marlin. She uses her nose to find and catch food. She's also really fast.
Whoa! Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Oh, no. This never happens.
Yeah, Tabs, it is dark in here. Wherever we are. Jerry!
Jerry? Blippi? Is that you in there? Oh no, hold on! Whoa! I scared a gray whale and she blew you right out of her blowhole? That never happens.
Thanks for getting us out of there, Jerry. Oh, you're all lit up.
I told you the ocean was full of surprises, didn't I?
Hey, look, it's your friends.
Hiya, pals. You guys found me.
And I found the answer to my question. What's underneath the ocean? There's a kelp forest, blue marlins, huge whales, and a jellyfish that lights up. Upload answer tabs.
And we're only on chapter one. In chapter two, there's an octopus and a shark and a sea turtle and a tuna.
Bye, Jerry.
Oh, and there's an otter, and a seahorse, and a lobster, and a stingray!
Whoa, look at that, Tabs! It's an adorable kitty cat! And look at those super long whiskers! I wonder, why do cats have whiskers? Great idea, Tabs! Let's follow that kitty cat and find out! I'm gonna need wings!
Wings confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station! Shrinking down! The Blippi Mobile is ready for adventure! Do you see any kitties yet, Tabs? Whoa! What was that? Hey! It's me, Blippi. What's your name?
Hipley's the name, and treats are my game. Say, you aren't holding out on me, are you?
Holding out on what?
Shh. Treats! I can smell them like hot cakes in the morning. They're close. Hurry, follow me.
Wait for me.
Yeehaw! Woo! Flawless.
How do you land so perfectly?
My whiskers have special sensors that help keep me oriented, so I always land on my feet. Like this!
Aha! Do you think you can fit?
My whiskers help me determine if I can fit through the passage without getting stuck. See? I told you. Come on, Blippi!
It's so dark! How can you see anything?
When I can't see what's around me, my whiskers tell me when something's there. Ah, rats! No treats in here. But we must be close. Come on, y'all!
What else can your whiskers do?
Even the slightest breeze can tell me information about my environment and what direction a smell is coming from. My whiskers are telling me that the treats are... Woo! There! Woo! Jackpot! Would you look at that? Woo-hoo-hoo! I'm happier than a pig in mud!
What a great adventure, Kipley! We found the treats! And I got the answer to my question. Why do cats have whiskers? Cats' whiskers help them navigate their environment and help them keep oriented so they always land on their feet. Upload answer tabs. Bye-bye, Kipley!
Thanks, Blippi. It was great to have you as a sidekick on this adventure. Bye, y'all!
Holy smokes! A volcano! That's right, D.BO. When a volcano erupts, smoke and hot lava come out the top of it. I wonder, what makes a volcano erupt? Great idea! We'll go inside a volcano and find out. I'm gonna need wings, spider legs, and the heat shield.
Wings, spider legs, heat shield, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi Mobile is ready for adventure. Let's go through the side vent into the volcano. Whoa, whoa! Oh, it sure is hot in here.
Hey there, I'm Maggie the Magma Monster.
Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is D.BO. We want to learn what makes a volcano erupt.
You're in for a real treat, Blippi and D.BO. Speaking of treats... Below us, deep in the Earth, the planet's heat is melting rocks into liquid, also known as magma, like me.
You're right, D.BO. It is like one of our favorite games. The floor is lava. Whoa!
Magma becomes lava after it erupts out of the volcano. So I guess I'm the floor.
Whoa! We're getting higher.
That's because the more rocks melt below, the more magma rises here in the chamber.
Hey, I wonder where this goes.
Look out, Blippi!
Magma! Phew, that was close. Maggie, you almost fill the whole cavern now.
I sure do. And as I grow, the pressure inside the volcano builds until we push through the crust or the top of the Earth. Hold on!
Whee!
Ah, much better.
Maggie, what a blast! And I got the answer to my question. What makes a volcano erupt? A volcano erupts when the hot magma inside it builds pressure and bursts through the surface of the Earth. Upload answer, D.BO.
That was fun, Blippi. Hope you loved it.
We did. Bye-bye, Maggie. Salad. Oh, thanks, Tabs. Didn't know this lettuce was stuck in my teeth. I guess a toothbrush would help. I wonder, how do you use a toothbrush to clean your teeth? Great idea! We can go meet a toothbrush in a mouth. I'm gonna need wings.
Wings confirmed.
Let's go explore! Activate Blippi Station! The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure. It's time to shrink down and go into a mouth. Shrinking down! We're inside a mouth. You're right, Tabs. We need a way to clean these teeth.
Would a brush help? Hi, I'm Bill Brushy. And you are?
Hey, it's me, Blippi, and this is Tabs. I want to find out how to use a toothbrush to clean teeth.
Well, you're asking the right brush. Hop on, and I'll show you the best way to clean your teeth.
All right. Hey, Bill Brushy, is that toothpaste on your brush part?
Yes, sir. It helps keep teeth healthy and food free. Okay, now here's how to brush your teeth. Let's go to the front first. So, small circles on every tooth.
Whoa!
Okay, that's the front done. Let's go to the back now.
We turned, we flipped.
Little circles round and round.
All right, let's make some more. Circles, circles, circles.
These teeth are the molars. I call them the chew crew, since they do most of the work.
I know, Tabs. Toothbrushing is a wild ride. Wow! I think I have the answer to my question. How do you use a toothbrush to clean your teeth? It cleans by brushing the front, back, and in between of all teeth in little circle motions. And that pushes all the food out from between the teeth and makes them nice and clean. Upload answer, Tabs.
Thanks for your help, Blippi and Tabs. Remember to brush twice a day for 2 minutes each time for super sparkling teeth.
We will. Thanks for letting us ride along, Brushy. Bye-bye. Gigantic truck! You're right, D.BO. I think that was a monster truck. I wonder, what makes a monster truck special? Good idea! We can catch up with that monster truck and find out. I'm gonna need monster truck wheels.
Monster truck wheels confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. D.BO? Whoa, D.BO! You have the monster truck wheels attachment? You're like a monster truck! All right, let's ride! D.BO the monster truck is ready for adventure!
Crash! Crash!
It's me, Blippi, and this is D.BO. You really crushed that car!
Hi, Blippi. I'm Megan.
So, Megan, we're here to find out what makes a monster truck special.
Cool. Well, I think the best way to answer your question is to show you what I do.
Great!
You see, I'm a monster truck with big, tall, monster tires. I'm 13 feet tall!
Wow!
Let's do this!
All right!
Crash!
We can't bounce as high as you, Megan! And, oh boy, we're almost tipping over!
Well, I have heavy-duty suspension, which are special springs, so I can bounce way up and down and not tumble over. I use them when I race and have competitions.
Cool! Whoa!
Yeah! Welcome aboard, Blippi! Buckle up! It's time to dominate the obstacle course!
Whoa!
Whoa!
Whoa! This is awesome! Ooh, how can you turn and zigzag so fast?
I have something called four-wheel steering, so I can turn all four wheels at once, instead of just two wheels like a lot of regular trucks. Us monster trucks are built for short, high-powered bursts of speed! I nailed that!
Megan, that was amazing! And I have the answer to my question. What makes a monster truck special? Monster trucks are a special kind of truck with big tires, heavy-duty suspension, and four-wheel steering. Upload answer, D.BO. Bye, Megan! It was so cool to ride with you!
Bye, Blippi! Keep on crushing!
Whoa! This spider web looks amazing! You're right, D.BO! Spider webs do have such artistic designs! I wonder, how do spiders make their webs? Yes! Let's go find a spider to ask! I'm gonna need wings and spider legs!
Wings, spider legs, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station! Shrinking down! The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure!
Bonjour, I'm Spencer! You're just in time to watch me make my latest artistic creation!
Hey, it's me, Blippi. Are you about to make a web?
I am! It's going to be my greatest masterpiece, the webbiest web of all time! Want to help?
Yeah! I really want to learn how spiders make their webs.
Time to create!
D.BO, I'll be right back.
Blippi, you can be my holder and tester! My web will be a circle-shaped design with some triangles in the middle.
What kind of string do you use to make your web?
I use silk strands that I make myself, and they shoot out of my stomach! To a spider or bug, these strands are as strong as steel!
That is so cool!
Next, the circles to complete my masterpiece! Can you hold this strand in place, Blippi?
Yeah! Whoa! It is a circle shape!
Ah, perfect! Grab that strand, Blippi, to swing out for a look!
Whoa! Amazing! Wait! Is that a picture of me in your web?
It is you, my masterpiece. Now you can test it, bounce against it, see if it holds. Whee!
Whoa!
The sticky part is for catching bugs to eat.
Your web is beautiful and useful, Spencer. And you answer my question. How do spiders make their webs? They use super strong and sticky silk strands to create a web with a cool circular design. Upload answer, D.BO. Thanks for showing us how you make a perfect web, Spencer. Bye-bye!
Au revoir!
Yum! These turkey sandwiches are going to be delicious! Oh, what a mess! Hey, look at that fly walk on the ceiling. I wonder, how do flies walk on the ceiling? I'm gonna need wings and spider legs.
Wings, spider legs, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. Shrinking down! the Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure. Hey, D.BO! I think I know that fly! It's Horace!
Hi, Blippi! How's it going, pal?
How did you get on the ceiling?
No, it's easy! Watch this! Ta-da!
Wow!
Yes, sirree! The ceiling is my own personal dance floor! Skip it, bit it, dip, 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 now you try!
Here goes! Whoa! Why can't the Blippi-mobile stand on the ceiling too? What's the trick?
Here's the trick! You've got to stick!
Stick?
Mm-hmm. You see, my feet make a super sticky glue that helps me stick to the ceiling. Here, try some!
Don't mind if I do. Here goes! Whoa! Oh, now I stick to the ceiling too.
Look at all that mess! Oh!
Oh, the glue has us stuck in place!
That's because you're not doing the fly leg twist!
The fly leg twist?
That's right! Fly glue is so strong that we have to push ourselves off the ceiling to walk! Like this!
Like this?
You got it! Now let's hit it! Do the fly leg twist, do the fly leg twist, and get your feet unstuck when you go like this!
We did it! And I have the answer to my question. How do flies walk on the ceiling? Fly legs have a special sticky glue that keeps them stuck to the ceiling. Upload answer, D.BO.
Well, I'm off to eat a little bit of dinner now. See you later, Blippi!
Bye-bye! Look at that cute little squirrel digging a hole! Did you see her bury that nut? So true, D.BO. We do need to know the answer. I wonder, why do squirrels bury their nuts? I'm gonna need the excavator arm and wings!
Excavator arm, wings, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station! Shrinking down! The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure! Look, D.BO! This is an acorn! It's a type of nut, and squirrels love them. Here, squirrely squirrely! We have an acorn over here!
Nuts! Nuts! I need more nuts! I can't get enough nuts!
Hey! It's me, Blippi! And this is my friend, D.BO. We found a nut for you.
Nut? Oh, thanks for the acorn, Blippi. My name is Sparky. I'm kind of a nut expert.
Then you have to tell us, Sparky. Why do squirrels bury their nuts?
What? You don't bury your nuts? Huh? Come with me. No time to waste. We need nuts, 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 and more nuts. This is the garden, my favorite place to collect and bury things. You know, I can bury 25 things an hour.
That's a lot of burying! How do you remember where you put it all?
I keep everything up here in the old furry head. My memory is amazing! You think you can remember like I can? You want to try it?
We sure do!
Okay, now watch! Okay, do you remember where I just buried all those acorns?
Of course we do. Easy peasy.
Not an acorn.
This is harder than I thought.
Hello, yummy walnut.
We can't find any acorns.
Right, because I take special care to hide my nuts so only I can find them. That's how I keep them safe. And then I'll dig them up in the winter when I'm hungry and food is harder to find.
So cool! And I found the answer to my question. Why do squirrels bury their nuts? squirrels bury their nuts and other things so they can eat them later and have enough food during the winter. Upload answer, D.BO. Bye, Sparky!
Bye-bye!
Keep digging! Moon taps?
Great!
Since I just finished my fun painting, can you guess what it is? Wow, Tabs, exactly right. It is a penguin holding a cup of tea while rollerblading through a jungle. So many colors.
Whoa,
a rainbow, so many colors. I wonder, how does a rainbow get its colors? Great idea, Tabs. We can fly up and ask the rainbow and find out. But first, I'm gonna need wings.
Wing confirmed.
Let's go explore! Activate Blippi Station! The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure. Let's go find out how a rainbow gets its colors.
Guys and gals, attention please! The big blue sky is proud to present nature's greatest influencer, I'm Bowie the Rainbow!
Whoa! Hey, it's me, Blippi! I'm a big fan, Bowie. I know all your colors.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm very proud of my colors. Let me show them off one by one. I don't.
Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet.
Wonderful job, Blippi. You know, today's a big day. We're doing a double rainbow showstopper. Oh, you must be part of my performance.
Really? I'd be honored, but I don't know how you get all your colors. Could you show me?
Of course, superfan Blippi. First, let's check out this puffy cloud called a cumulus cloud. Ooh, it looks like it just rained too, which is perfect. That means there are lots of water droplets in the air.
Wow, this cloud has so many teeny drops of water.
Hashtag true. Okay, next step, position the cloud so the sunlight shines through the water droplets, like this. Now, when the light goes through the water, it bends, or refracts, and separates the light into all the colors of the rainbow. Voila!
That is awesome! I think I have the answer to my question. How does a rainbow get all its different colors? It's when the sunlight shines through water. It bends the light and separates the light into all the colors of the rainbow. Upload answer, Tabs.
A 5, 6, 7, 8.
Wow!
Don't forget to like and subscribe. How you doing? All right, see you later, Blippi.
Woo! Wow, that bee sure seems busy. And so does that one. And that one too. They're all so busy. Well, except that one. Those bees are busy making honey. I wonder, how do bees make honey? Yes, let's go into the beehive. I'm gonna need wings and the excavator arm.
Wings, excavator arm, confirmed.
Activate Blippi Station. The Blippi-mobile is ready for adventure. Now, we just need to make like a bee and be tinier. Shrinking down. You're right, Tabs. The bee's tongue is in the flower. Hey, it's me, Blippi. This is Tabs. I was wondering how you make honey.
Hey, Blippi, I'm Bijon. Honey, huh? This is the place to be. So I'm using my tongue to drink in this sweet nectar. It's how we bees start to make honey. Okay, time to buzz. Into the beehive. Follow me. Spoiler, lots of bees working. It's like a honey factory in there.
Bijon, are they all chewing nectar?
Sure are. Gotta chew, that's what we do. Chewing makes it thicker. Can't have runny honey. I rhymed again!
And after you chew, then you have honey?
No, no, there's more to show. We chew, then we swallow. The nectar stays in our bellies, becomes honey, then we put it in the honeycomb.
The honeycomb?
Yep, we store the honey in the honeycomb.
Maybe I can taste some honey.
Oh dear. This may look funny, but flapping our wings is how we make thicker honey. It's a bee thing.
Whoa! Yes, Tabs, I have the answer to my question. How do bees make honey? They get nectar from flowers, chew it, store it in their stomachs, then put the honey in a honeycomb and flap their wings over it. Upload answer, Tabs. Bye, Bijan. Thanks for being you.